the Q80T 4K HDR TV. It's Samsung's entry-level full-array local dimming TV for 2020. And since I have it in for review, I'll be doing a gaming test and demo so you guys can see what it's like to game on it. Stick around. Hey guys, it's the Villaman here, home theater enthusiast and all around tech lover. And since I have the Samsung Q80T in for review, as always with every TV I review, I like to do a gaming demo, and this is no different. Now, as I said in the intro, the Q80T is a full array local dimming TV, and it has an HDMI 2.1 port which supports VRR variable refresh rate and FreeSync, as well as a 120Hz refresh rate. The One X just can't do 4K at 120Hz because it's not an HDMI 2.1 device. So this could be a great choice for gaming on the PS5 or the Xbox Series X when it comes out. We'll see. Today we're playing Borderlands, so let's see how it handles 4K gaming. The TV has Game Motion Plus enabled by default, which I'm not a big fan of at all. So the first thing I did, or the first setting I changed, was to disable that because it just doesn't make the game look or feel very, very gamey. It feels unnatural. Disabling the Game Motion Plus actually makes it look better. I'm not sure why Samsung thinks they need to have that enabled. If you like your gaming without weird motion and artifacts, then I suggest you disable this setting. FreeSync is not compatible with the Game Motion Plus setting, so you have to either enable one or the other. You can't have both. But given the choice, I know the more sane amongst you will choose to have FreeSync.
In my image, yeah, good idea. From chisel jaw to legendary calves. First up, go find all my wanted posters. P.S. I am very wanted. We're gonna pull this off. We're gonna need those pictures of me to feed into the 3D scanner thing. Then we just start putting up statues to look like me instead. That'll really tick off the Calypsos.
It takes everything!
It's funny. Because the input lag is low that or is so low. It's super responsive. I'm not even thinking about aiming. It just aims right. So one of the things that I noticed, some TV manufacturers, their default picture is either very desaturated, or in some cases it's just right, so not oversaturated and not desaturated. Samsung is one of those where the picture, I think, is just right. It's not desaturated, and the colors look vivid enough that you look like you're playing an actual colorful game. Got chumps. Okay, why can't I aim right now? I believe that is what they call a slaughter. Whoa, who's that? Whoa. Holy crap. Okay, I did not expect that. What is this? not your favorite.
And the world quaked in terror.
That was beautiful, wasn't it? I'm seeing some stuttering, which I'm not sure if it's skipped frames, but...
Keep fighting, Vault Hunter!
Can you see it? Gameplay is much smoother with FreeSync enabled. Before I saw some stuttering, but now I don't.
Stadium.
Okay, I can arrange that. So what can I say? Gaming on this TV is what you'd expect from a TV with such prominent gaming features. The One X can output up to 1440p at 120Hz, but at 120Hz the TV only accepts a 1080p signal, which is strange. It's good that this TV supports FreeSync, because having that enabled actually eliminated the stutter that I was experiencing with the game at certain intervals. So it would drop frames, and in this case when I enabled FreeSync, that disappeared completely. I also like how the TV handled sound in game mode. It had real stereo separation because of the Samsung object tracking sound that it has. Input lag is also a non-issue, but that's been the case with every QLED TV that I've reviewed so far. But yeah, don't forget to check out the full review for my complete thoughts on this TV. Don't forget to like the video if you liked it or found it helpful, and subscribe to the channel for more TV reviews and demos like this one. Thanks for watching, and until next time, this has been your friendly neighborhood Villaman saying, peace, and be safe.